Hello world, Mike Rackets. Today we will connect four temperature sensors and get temperature data. The sensor themselves. Already familiar DHT11 from it. In addition to temperature, you can also get the value of air humidity. Thermistor KY013. This temperature sensor decreases its resistance in proportion to the increase in temperature. DS18B20 sensor works via one-wire interface, provides temperature data in digital form. And the last sensor is in the microcontroller. Let's try to do some small tests. To do this, you need two glasses. Pour cold water with ice into the left one and boiling water into the right one. The first to check will be the DS18B20 sensor. We put it into hot water, trying not to close the contacts. The case heats up very quickly and the temperature reading on the display exceeds 70 degrees Celsius. Now in the cold. Ice cubes cool well and we see that the temperature is dropping up to about 15 degrees. Select the next sensor from the menu. This is an NTC thermistor. Heats up quickly from the warmth of the hand, and it cools down just as quickly in cold water. We put it in hot water. The temperature is also over 70 degrees. To reset the entire system, press the reset button. Select the DHT11 sensor, menu item 3. So we press the button 3. After all the pictures are shown, we go into endless cycle of receiving the temperature from the sensor. The sensor housing is not intended for bathing in water. But if we hold it longer, we see that the temperature is dropping. It works better with hot water. The case heats up quickly. And what about the fourth sensor? Internal sensor number 4 is the data that the microcontroller itself generates. It has an internal thermal sensor to which an ADC channel can be connected. However, his readings may differ significantly. The sensor data can have a spread of plus minus 45 degrees, wherefore its use is limited. The real temperature of a controller is about 35 degrees. In addition, we will consider the option of displaying all sensors at once. These 18B20 sensor, here is its temperature. The NTC sensor is its temperature. DHT11 sensor, here is its temperature. Last sensor is located in the microcontroller and slightly changes the temperature from the heat of the hand. Consider the electrical circuit. DS18B20, NTC resistor and DHT11 are used as sensors. The touch keyboard is responsible for the choice of a sensor. All the sensor and the brains of a system are located in the microcontroller. Graphic information is shown on the display. Pictures for sensors are stored in external SPI flash memory. Sensors provide information in digital form, except for NTC. Let's take a closer look at his work. It consists of two resistances, a thermistor and a constant resistance. We write down the formulas for Kirchhoff's law and Ohm's law. We express the resistance of a thermistor through constant resistance and the ADC code. A simplified B formula is used to obtain the temperature. Coefficients B and R25 should be viewed in the datasheet for the thermistor. Let's move on to programming. In the main function, we call the initialization procedures. We also set up the objects used. These are input-output pins and additional parameters. In an endless loop, we display it, turn the menus and sensor images with the required delay. In case of pressing the button, the following code is executed, displaying a picture of a sensor and an endless cycle of obtaining temperature data. This is done for all four buttons. Receiving temperature from DS18B20 sensor. Reset device. Send command by skipping ROM commands. Set temperature resolution. Then reset the device and start the conversion procedure. We are waiting for the appropriate time for conversion. Reset the device and read its RAM bit by bit. We check the checksum, and if everything converges, when we select the integer, fractional and symbolic parts of a temperature, receiving temperature from anti-C thermistor, start ADC conversion and timer. We are waiting for the timer to restart the ADC conversion the required number of times. We use the resulting data array to calculate the arithmetic mean. We calculate the resistance value by the formula. We calculate the temperature value by the formula. We translate from Kelvin to Celsius. Receiving temperature from DHT11 sensor. We send a reset pulse to the sensor. Next, we transfer the pin of a microcontroller to the input mode and wait for sensor response. During this time, the timer captures in PWM mode. We transfer the pin of a microcontroller back to push-pull mode. We check the number of receiving special bits and begin to analyze their duration. If the duration is correct, fill in the array of decoded values. We calculate the checksum for data verification. If everything is the same, then we select the value for temperature and humidity. Receiving temperature from the internal sensor of the microcontroller. We launch the ADC and DMA channel. We work in conjunction. We are waiting for the end of the channel. Calculate the arithmetic mean from the received digital data. We translate the ADC code into volts. To calculate the temperature, we use the formulas from the datasheet and reference manual. The accuracy is poor. The spread can reach plus minus 45 degrees. This sensor is not controlled in production. Additional function for driving BMP file. We transfer its address to the beginning of a graphic data in external flash memory. It uses double buffering and line-by-line image output. The loop reads data from external memory into string buffers, in turn and display them on the display. When one buffer is full, it immediately starts reading the next one and displaying the current one. This achieves a high speed of work. That's all. See you in the next video. Subscribe, MicroCat.